Hi, hello. I'm welcoming you all for the presentation Expert System course. This session is intended to answer certain questions generally arise when you see the posted video. I'm Dr. S. Suresh, Associate Professor in Computer Science and Engineering, PA College of Engineering Technology, Pollachi, Coimbatore District, Tamil Nadu. The following questions one may interested to arise. So for an example, what is expert system? Expert system is a software capable of intelligently responding to any questions like a human experts. So for an example, suppose Vishwanathan Anand comes, then you can interact with him and can raise any questions to him as far as chess is concerned. Similarly, Sachin Tendulkar comes, he is a cricket expert. You can raise plenty of questions and know the tactics from him. So similarly, expert systems is the intelligent complex systems capable of responding like a human domain experts. Why one would need it is a question you can ask. The very simplest answer is, suppose you want to interact with that human experts, human domain experts, then that's not possible in all cases, as well as money speaks a lot. There cannot be a one-to-one interaction very easily. However, the software expert system capable of responding you one-to-one interaction is possible, and it answers openly. So that is the reason of expert systems. Why the name expert systems? The very simplest thing is, as it is replace the human experts, human expertise personality, the term expert comes. The system is a generic term used to mention that collection of interconnected components integrated together to accomplish certain aim or objective. To attain certain aim or objective. So that is the reason expert system comes. Expert, human expert, replaces human expert, that's why expert system. How does it differ from the conventional system? This is where the most intelligent thing of the expert system. See, you know, conventional system is not capable of responding your questions. It's capable of merely the instruction that you have embedded and how you have programmed. It ever uses any knowledge base, there is no inference and so on. However, expert system having inference engine and having the ability of reasoning, the most important thing. That's why the term intelligence. What it can do is, it can get the fact from you and with the help of the knowledge base where the rules are available, what to do, how to do, previous experience. And by using some algorithm, it can deduce for the particular questions. So this is what the major difference between expert system and the conventional system. What are the application of the expert system? Enormous. There is no limit for expert systems. Let's say for an example, it can be used for suppose machine repairing. Consider a data centers where somewhere that error has happened, it is capable of telling where the error would have happened. Some major thing, no? Otherwise, if it needs a human intervention, that would be a very toughest thing. Similarly, lens designing, then car problem somewhere, if something went wrong, capable of responding. That's what I have simply mentioned it as industrial and commercial problems. How expert system works? Another question one can raise. Very simple. It uses three components. User interface, where the user can interact with the expert system, like a GUI, graphical user interface. See, when you interact with the machine, you can see desktop, no? Double click. That's what a GUI, right? Similarly, user interface is a graphical user interface where the user can interact. They are end users. The user interface can interact with the inference engine component to and fro. The inference engine, with the help of the knowledge base where the rules or experience are associated or given in if then rules. With the help of that, what it can do is, whatever the user asks the question, it searches in the knowledge base and deduce the reasoning. So this is what the working logic of the working methodology of the expert system. What are the major components of an expert system? So previous question itself I have answered what is a components. The most essential one is inference engine. Inference engine is, it is the reason behind the reasoning, right? That's what the ability of intelligence, human intelligence. Inference engines, then a knowledge base where the rules are associated and the experience are available. User interface is the area where one can interact. So major components are inference engine, knowledge base, user interface. What are the research areas of ES? See, as people says, as there is a say, no system is perfect. Still, expert system also being updated, and researchers are working towards refining this. The most essential part that I have mentioned is analysis of earthquake damage and forecasting crop damage. However, still the plenty of research areas are going on as far as ES is concerned. Mention the various building blocks of ES. Already the question is answered in the previous slide, that is what are the major components of expert system. If you have a further look, then we can have mentioned the various building blocks of ES. Knowledge base editor, explanation subsystem, inference engine, general knowledge base, case specific data. These are all some of the additional components, subcomponents that is available in the expert system. Knowledge base editor. The use of the knowledge base editor is, with the help of the knowledge base editor, the knowledge engineer can imbibe the knowledge. Explanation subsystem is another interesting important component that is available in the ES, which is capable of explaining why it comes for the conclusion. That's what explanation subsystem. It helps for debugging. Inference engine. I already explained about what is the interesting of an inference engine. General knowledge base. That's what the knowledge base. Then case specific data or fact data. So this is what various building blocks of ES. What strategy does the inference engine use for the inference? This question one can arise. Generally two algorithms inference engine uses for deducing or comes for the conclusion. One is forward chaining algorithm and another one is backward chaining algorithm. The forward chaining algorithm is rarely used and the backward chaining algorithm is most widely used in expert systems. Forward chaining algorithm means you ask a question by giving the fact and it responds. However, backward chaining algorithm, you are giving the answer. Say for an example, he has a cancer, why it comes, how it comes, what is the reason behind the patient cancer, then it will come to the list out the factors why because it happened. That's what backward chaining algorithm. So expert system use backward chaining algorithm. How the knowledge base be updated? There is a special component is available. Its name is knowledge base editor. A knowledge engineer, if you want to keep update the knowledge base, then with the help of the knowledge editor, he can include as a if then else rules. Mention the inference process. So the three steps or the phases are match, select, execute. Means that it collects the data of fact from the user and match it with the knowledge base and select and store it in conflict selection, because there can be a plenty of rules are there, and it chooses the most appropriate rule and fire it. This is what the inference process. Illustrate the usage of explanation system. Explanation of the reasoning process. List down the developmental phases of the ES, the most thing important one, how expert systems are developed. It can be said to be the, I hope everyone is aware of SDLC, software development lifecycle. Similarly, this is also the same thing, but the phases are project initialization, initially analyze which domain which technology can be used. These sort of things comes under project initialization. Next is system analysis and design, a prototype design, then a requirement analysis of the user, what will be the output, sketch, and so on. Prototyping, that is some simple model sketch. Then a system development, coding, input, output, how the components are interconnected together. These sort of the things are all comes under system development. Implementation, coding, you can choose the appropriate suitable language for the development. Post implementation, where that implementation, maintenance are accomplished. So these are all the phases of development phases. How the new rules are added to the knowledge base? The question is already answered. Let me tell you once again, with the help of the knowledge base editor, the knowledge engineer can interact and edit the knowledge base. Thanks for your listening. Thank you.